back to my channel. Today I'm going to show you a software that will help you to download high resolution satellite imagery, conventional maps that can be inserted georeferenced into any GIS software or as a background for your CAD drawing. The software is called SAS Planet. It's a Russian software, but there is an English version of it. It is a free and open source software. Go to the download page. The link is going to be displayed below the video. Look for the latest release, in this case January 22. Click on it and download the software. You see it is 15.15 megabyte, a rather small software. It will take a few seconds to download it. Open the download folder and unzip the software. As you can see, this software doesn't need to be installed. Just take the whole directory, cut it and paste it somewhere on your hard drive. I like to paste it under program file. Fine. At this point, the software appears under the program file directory, and ideally you run it as an administrator so that you can be sure that there will be a connection with the internet. Here we are. Now you zoom to the area of interest. Let's assume that you want this image as a background map. But here you can see the option that you have. You can see on the left the zoom level that you are displaying. If you zoom out, the level decreases. If you zoom in, the level increases. As far as I know, you can go up to a maximum of 24 zoom. Then you can choose the type of map that you would like to display. You have Bing, Esri, other type of map. Just go through and check. You have a big choice. It is a Russian software, therefore you have a better choice in those area of the ex-Soviet Union, like Ukraine for example, could be interesting. You have OpenStreetMap, Yahoo, Yandex. Okay, let's take Bing Map Satellite. This one, let's say that I want this village as a background map as a higher resolution. Click now here, click on visible area, go to download, click the zoom that you want to download. In that case I want the highest possible zoom, 24, and click start. You can see the number of files that are going to be downloaded. Of course, bigger the map and higher the zoom, this will take more files and more time. In this case, it will take 40 minutes for this high resolution map. It is too big, and for the matter of the video, I will make a smaller area. Otherwise we have to wait too much. Same process. 24. Start. And now there are only 2000 files. It will take 3 minutes for this small area. You need of course a good internet connection. Almost finished. Fine. The task is complete. 2065 files downloaded into the cache. You can quick at this point, click again here, click on visible area again, click on stitch, choose the output format. You can take a GeoTIFF, choose the zoom that you want to, that case 24. You can check the projection, that's fine. Click on point W, this will create the projection file. and choose the location where you want to save the file and put a name. And click on start. This might take a little bit time, but less than before. Process is finished. Let's have a look. Now we have a picture called Grone Tiff. It is 261 megabyte. Let's have a look. Quality. Of course, if you take JPEG, the size will be smaller. Here you have it. Fine, and let's import it in our Quantum GIS. Click on Open Data Source Manager, Raster. Let's have a look. Open, add, and close. Here we are. Now you can see we have our image offline. We can start to work on this image. At this point, you can as well upload your image into AutoCAD or ArchiCAD. But before closing the tutorial, just verify that your image is properly georeferenced. I click on Web, Quick Map Service, and just take another image, for example, Google Earth. And here you can see that the image is properly georeferenced. And as well, it has a better resolution compared to Google Earth. Thank you very much. I hope you enjoy it and see you soon.